I'm here today with some lamps. I've been 3D printing lamps, and some of them take quite a while. Some of them are really cool, and then one has been very expensive. I think I've got about $75 in one of these lamps now, and I still can't quite get it to work right. So let's take a look at one of the ones that I did first, and I think is probably the cool. It looks pretty boring right now, right? It's just the moon. This print definitely takes a little bit of time, but it is totally worth it. I even used the wrong filament. I ordered the filament the guy in the model said to use, and then I had two whites in and I confused them, and it still came out amazing. So I think this would work pretty well with any white. Let's go ahead and turn it on here. Isn't that amazing? And then in the intro, you saw it in the dark. And all we're using here is the little LED light base that Bamboo sells. I'll have a link to that. But like, this thing is just so cool. I did a Marco Polo of this when I first made it, and my brother-in-law immediately printed one as his next print, and his kids love it. They've got it on a Amazon Echo, so they can just tell it to turn it on and off. And it's so cool. Let me turn the light off again here for a second. Like, I just love this thing so much. You've got so much detail here. There will be a link to this in the description so you can get this file yourself. It is such a fun print. I wish someone would do this with Mars. There's just, I don't think we have as high res imagery of the surface of Mars yet. But I think that would be really neat. So, real simple, you know, it's hollow on the inside. It's pretty thin walls. Let's look at this crater here. Let me pick this up. Like, isn't that so neat? You got all these craters and... I just love this thing. I don't know. I'm a huge space nerd, always have been. Maybe not so much in recent years because, you know, adulting. But, like, this thing is just freaking so cool. So let's take a look at the next lamp that I really like. We'll go ahead and leave the light off. Sorry if I'm blinding you there with the LED. So I also like Minecraft a lot. Before I got married, I just started playing Minecraft. And I'd say the first year of my marriage, when we were in a tiny one-bedroom apartment, you know, when we were watching TV or whatever in the bedroom, I would just sit there and play Minecraft. And then I moderated a Minecraft server for a while too. It's kind of hard to get this to show up. So let me go turn the light back on. That's better. So I found that some of these lamps, including the moon here, you kind of want some light in the room. They look a lot better. They don't do so well in complete darkness. I think you need some of the light playing off the surface for this one. And then for this, it's okay as a light on its own, but it's more just like a... kind of like a decorative piece, I think. It's pretty simple. I love how this all snaps together and everything. Let me turn this light off for a second so I don't blind you guys again. So this was a super simple print. You know, you print all the gray stuff. You printed these. This is just one color, and it varies the thickness to get the light effect. And then, you know, you print the brown pieces. And they all snap together really nicely. They're not coming off. I mean, you could get them apart, but they're real nice fit connections, real nicely tight fit connections. You don't have to worry so much about gluing it or anything. It just snaps together. And, you know, there are some little imperfections here and there, but like, this thing is just so cool. And someone on this file, if you go on there, they've made a chain that's linked. So you can actually have the chain like in Minecraft. And then obviously you could change this to any color you want. You could put the blue in there for the, what's it called? Soul Flame Lantern or whatever. And you could just do your own custom ones too, like red or orange or whatever. But this thing is just so satisfying. And like, you can pick it up. It's not going anywhere. It's got nice cable routing. It's so fun. There's room for you to put, like little felt or rubber anti-skid pads or whatever so you don't scratch up a surface. Very well thought out design. I wish someone would do a torch. If you know of a torch version, I would love that because that would be so cool too. You could probably do it exactly the same, have these snap connections in the brown and then go up into the actual flame part. Let's get to my failure now. And I say it's a failure because even though I've successfully done it now, it just, I'm not satisfied. I can't get it to work properly. Just reach over here and grab these. So there's the first failure. There's my second attempt, which came out much nicer. Here's the other parts. So with this failure, the model maker did warn you that the support material is going to be a pain. And they weren't kidding. They did the brain in white. I went ahead and did it in this, it's a bamboo color. I forget what it is. I bought it for desert sand for Minecraft, and then it came out looking a whole lot more like skin. So I was like, well, I don't need as much of this as I bought for Minecraft sand. So let me use some of it for skin prints. And instead, I use it on a brain here. And I think it came out pretty good. But yeah, this model uses a ton of supports. And that is about 45 minutes of work right there, trying to get all these supports off. And there's still a ton. And this is only, you know, half of the brain. So then I went expensive and I did it again. And I used Bamboo's support interface material. Came out much, much better. Took me probably 20 minutes to get both pieces completely cleaned. There's still a couple of random ones I see like in deep crevices sometimes, but for the most part, I got, yeah, here's some right here. I don't know if you can see that. Is it gonna focus? Right in there. That I cannot get out for the life of me. Yeah, so if you see these little indentations here, this is supposed to be how you stand it on the table. And for the life of me, I cannot get it to stand. As you can see here, it's not the easiest thing to try to do. Stands fine like that. Let me set it back. Oh, see, I just touched it and it fell over. But once I put the other top on, or the top on, and then I get the light in there, because the light goes in here, and this kind of lifts it up, and I cannot get it to stay standing. I don't know if you can hear that by the microphone. There's some pieces in there of support filament that I just can't get out. They're down in here, so they rattle. But, I mean, it looks amazing as a brain. Let's see, it goes this way. Yeah, even when I just try to put the top on, it just wants to fall over constantly. And that's not how it's supposed to stand on there, but you kind of get the idea. Just a failure. And like I said, I have about 2 kilograms almost of this color filament in here. And then I have, because this wasn't my first attempt at doing the support filaments, I actually ran out of filament while I was asleep. And by the time I woke up, it had been 4 hours, so the top layer had cooled. So I had to print one of the sections again. So I lost a ton of support filament. That one's on me. I should have kept better track of how much was on the roll or had a second roll in the AMS ready to kick in. So all in all, I think I'm like $70, $75 on this thing, not including, you know, the LED. Would I recommend this model? Absolutely not. Like, it is a nightmare. You know, you just use your PLA filament or whatever, and it's such a pain in the butt. So if you're using the support interface, you're still leaving those pieces left, like I showed you, and it's just, I don't know. Maybe in the white it would have done better, but in this flesh color that I'm using, like, even when it lights up, it's just very localized, and I don't know. It's not what I was expecting. Still pretty cool. I may, yeah, see, I can't get it to even sit on anything. It just wants to completely fall off. So I don't know. Maybe we'll keep the top part as a Halloween decoration. I don't know, maybe not, because it's still pretty ugly. And you know, you win some, you lose some with 3D printing. I make these mistakes, so hopefully you don't. If you want to try this model, go for it. But, you know, I personally wouldn't. I'd like to see if you can masterfully pull it off. Or if someone knows why I can't get it to stand. I just think there was a lot of weird stuff going on with this. It has so many likes and bookmarks. And I think maybe like 5 people have actually printed it. Because there's no way that a ton of people have successfully printed this. Even the few comments are people that have had tons of problems. And from a distance, it looks okay, but as soon as you get up on it, you can see all the layer lines. You know, you get those little like topographic swirls, and you actually get this side by side, and yeah. If it lit up well as a lamp, I think it's just way too thick for this filament to do it. But I think, you know, I don't know. I'd be curious to see someone try this in clear. Just so disappointed with this. I really wanted it to be cool. And, you know, like this thing is amazing. I keep meaning to buy another one of the LED bases from Bamboo and then set this up somewhere in the living room and put it on a smart switch, because it really is cool. And the Minecraft one's cool too, but like, I think it's cool just not even on. Let me find room for it here. Like, you can kind of already get the impression of it there. And I wonder if you put like a tea light in there or something, you know, how cool it would look and everything. So yeah, that's been my attempts at three lights. If you've done any cool lights, tell me about them in the comments. Or tag me on Instagram in your photos. It's just at Ryan Mercer. I would love to see them. We've just been having so much fun decorating our house with this stuff. And yeah, I just love printing stuff. I definitely am addicted. But I will see you guys in the next video, and I hope you have a nice day.